Chef Soundarajan has handled several important assignments, including catering to former prime ministers and the various heads of states. He also won the Best Chef of India award in 2007. He's here on our show today to tell us all about his new book, The Essential Culinary Guide. Chef Soundarajan comes from a family which has been closely associated with producing an array of natural food ingredients for generations now. Though Chef Soundarajan graduated with a BSc in maths, he decided to listen to his inner voice and pursue a career in the catering and hospitality business.
I am a person who likes to create and innovate. So after completing my course in BSc Mathematics, though I can pursue in MSc Mathematics, I took up hospitality industry. Hospitality industry has got abundant scope. So after joining hospitality industry, I thought for creativity and innovation, the career in culinary art is a best choice.
Chef Soundarajan recently launched his book titled The Essential Culinary Guide, which is not just your usual recipe book. In fact, it does not have a single recipe in it.
All culinary books in the world are either comprises of recipes or techniques or ingredients. But this book is all about culinary techniques. This book has got more than 5,000 culinary techniques for the global cuisine. The idea of picking up this book has come out to me about 20 years back when I was working under a French chef who used to write small snippets about each recipe and keep it. I thought it's a great idea to have it as a reference book. I started writing small snippets, and at the end of the day, just about 3 years back, I thought that I can put it together as a book of culinary techniques.
The Essential Culinary Guide has taken Chef Soundarajan about 3 years to conceptualize and develop. Filled with what he has learned from his hands-on approach over the years, it is sure to be a true companion to chefs in the making.
If you see in the culinary history of last 100 years, there were quite a few books on culinary techniques. And most of these books have dealt with the Western cuisine. But this book, The Essential Culinary Guide, cuts across all these books, and it shows you all the culinary techniques for the global cuisine put on the same platform. This book is for the people who want to make menu, from the manager. This book is for the chefs who is passionate about cooking, for the students, for the food writers, and this book is all for everyone around the world who is all passionate about food.
Chef Soundarajan is keen to continue contributing via the written word and come up with pieces of work that will be a reference point for generations to come. So perhaps a recipe-oriented book next time around?
Definitely it's not going to be a recipe book, because there are millions of recipes available in different forms. It's going to be a book which I'm sure I'm going to do a lot of research and do a book on culinary arts, science and management, which will help the younger chefs around the world.
The Essential Culinary Guide is priced at Rs. 390 and available at leading bookstores nationwide. Well, next up is a story of how boredom is not always a bad thing, because sometimes it can open up exciting and unexpected avenues for you, and more importantly, a story that shows you that if you follow something with passion, life could be an adventure.
1998, the year Peter Van Gate came to India to start and guide a team of software professionals. Peter landed in Chennai, skeptic and scared of this unknown land. But having a spirit of adventure, he was soon bored with what the city had to offer. He then bought an Enfield, put it on a train, and headed to the Western Ghats in Kerala. And before he knew it, he had completed 50,000 kilometers on his bike and had traveled thrice to the Himalayas.
Chennai Trekking Club actually got its roots a couple of years ago. Somewhere end of 97, beginning of 98, I used to go exploring in the weekends, go for treks with a couple of my friends from the company. So at that time the company was called Scientific Atlanta. Later on it got taken over by Cisco a couple of years ago. So once, like every month or every couple of months, we went to some places in, say, in Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka. So we went to this Gingi, we went to the Tada waterfalls in Andhra, we went to Shakleshpur, a beautiful railway track in Karnataka. So kind of we finished like 10 treks within the company. And after that, I kind of was interested to kind of go more in, go for more frequent treks, kind of try to go out almost every couple of weeks.
Left to accompany him, Peter decided to find like-minded people and started a blog in February 2008, where he requested everyone to share their trekking experiences. In a couple of months, the blog picked up pace and is now one of South India's largest and most active trekking groups.
Chennai Trek is special in a couple of ways, in the sense that first of all it's like non-profit. It's not like a commercial group like you find many out there. It's like fully non-profit. People come together and they do it for the passion of it. They share the expenses at the end of the weekend, like fuel and food expenses. It's also volunteer-based, so nobody's kind of, we don't have one organizer. Everyone actually who participates in the trek will contribute to, say, buying food before the trek, arranging transportation, setting up the campsite, carrying some extra luggage, kind of gathering firewood in the jungle to kind of cook, as well as, there are a lot of things to be done actually in a trek.
Enjoyment is not the only motive of the members, who use Chennai Trekking Club also as a platform for social initiatives. They help spread environmental awareness, take up campaigns like coastal cleanup, and believe in knowledge sharing through workshops on topics ranging from navigation, maps to photography, snakes and survival.
Recently, then also we have kind of started diversifying a little bit. So where it initially started with just like regular treks, really pure treks, we have come up with a lot of other initiatives. One of the initiatives we kind of started since January 2009 are the social treks. Social treks are treks where we will identify a home, and typically an orphanage in or around Chennai. Typically, this happens on a Sunday. It's a one-day event where we go to the home with volunteers. We have, say, 30 to 40 to 50 volunteers. We drive with our own bikes and cars. We go to the home, we pick up like 30 to 40 orphans from the home, and then take them on a full one-day event, like a small, easy kind of picnic type of trek, where the kids can kind of enjoy themselves.
Belgian by birth but Chennaiite by choice, Peter is fascinated by India's natural beauty and says there's a lot to be explored in this country. Though he has travelled world over, Chennai is where his heart lies.
I indeed kind of fell in love with Chennai over the years, as there are so many beautiful places around Chennai. I remember I used to go home in the early years, like every 6 months, once in a while to Belgium. But recently it has been actually years since I went home. I don't miss Belgium anymore that much. And I feel very at home. I mean, all my friends are here, my work is here, my home is here. So it's kind of, I feel more at home basically in Chennai than in any other place.
Chennai Trekking Club has completed over 250 treks, has over 8,700 members and continues to grow. What sets this club aside from the rest is that a group of strangers turn into friends, and at times, friends for life.
So for all those who want to live life on the edge, get your backpacks ready, as the Chennai Trekking Club promises that each and every trek will be a rewarding experience. On the other side, we have for you the Manonmani Vilasam Press, which has been producing the Pambu Panchangam since 1884.